We haven't talked about Rivian in a while, and I was hoping that the next time we could talk about them, it would be because deliveries had officially begun, which I do think is kind of a big deal. You know, Tesla is kind of alone in the startup all-electric car company that's actually begun delivering vehicles. We have a lot of companies that are talking about delivering vehicles, but Rivian just seemed really, really close. They said deliveries were going to be in June, and then they got pushed till July, and then they got pushed till September. So every time they push their deliveries, I'm getting a little bit more skeptical of their timelines, and it's not because I think delivering vehicles is easy. Obviously, it is very, very hard, and even Tesla is very often late on delivering their own vehicles because challenges arise, and getting supply chains in check and manufacturing everything ends up being a lot more complicated than most people at the company think, and that's why there's always some overly ambitious timeline that the CEOs lay out, and I want to get more angry because that would be fair. You know, I get annoyed when Tesla delays things. I get annoyed when Lucid delays things. I think it's just safe in the industry overall to just assume all electric vehicles are going to be late because these are very complicated products that are still relatively new to the automotive space. But the truth is, outside of the delayed delivery windows, Rivian is doing so many things I love, and I want to give them a ton of credit for it. And honestly, even though I'm a huge Cybertruck fan, I still think the Rivian R1T and R1S are pretty impressive vehicles, and I love that they're going after a market that doesn't feel very crowded. It doesn't feel like Tesla is going after this market or really that much else in the automotive space. So today's video is mainly just listing a few of the things that I appreciate Rivian is doing outside of course, delayed deliveries, which I hope happen as soon as possible within the month of September, as they're saying now, would be amazing. But for one, they've decided to include the built-in air compressor accessory. So before, this was apparently an add-on. If you paid for that add-on, now they're just going to refund you and not charge you at all for it. And essentially, this is an air compressor that's built into the bed of the truck that has a tube which can reach all four wheels. So if you want to pump up the air pressure in your tires, you'll be able to do that with the onboard accessory. A lot of people seem to be really happy about that, deciding to be thrown in with all of Rivian's vehicles, which is awesome. For two, they completed a private funding round. So another little side note there is I'm very grateful Rivian is still not publicly traded. These days, I think everyone kind of turns every EV company into a quick way to get rich. And I know that young EV startups want to get funding because it's expensive to build these cars, but I just applaud Rivian for being able to get this far in production and with their factories and tons of road testing going on. And despite all of that, they don't have to pump a stock all the time. Eventually, you probably gotta go public. I'm sure they will, but I'm just proud that there's some companies out there trying to stay private until they actually have delivered a product and they have customers. And then when you want to go public to scale up production, I guess I don't have as big an issue with it, but when you haven't delivered a product yet, but you're asking people to buy your stock, it just comes across a little too Nikola for me. But the main news is, because of this new funding round, they're actually searching the United States for a second factory location, which is good. I think that all EV startups that plan on having a major future should probably be ramping production of their current vehicles and trying to get them to customers as quickly as possible, but also looking for exact and clear ways of expanding. They raised a couple $1 billion, which can easily build another factory right now. They have one in Normal, Illinois. They're scouting the US for another one. I wouldn't be shocked if they try to go near Texas. But yeah, RJ has alluded to the fact that Rivian is probably going to be order constrained and supply constrained for demand for the next couple years because they simply don't have enough batteries. And a slight concern I have with Rivian is them prioritizing the delivery vans a little bit too much over the R1S and R1T. I don't want them to just turn into the Amazon van company, although I understand Amazon's a big shareholder of the company and they provide a lot of the money. So I'm happy to see delivery vans from Rivian are actually in use. You know, they're not delivering in super high volume, but they are being used to deliver packages. And that means that Rivian has technically, even if this is in beta and testing period, they have technically delivered a vehicle to a company that has ordered them and they are now using them for their intended purpose. So gives them a little bit more credit than just the typical company posting renderings on a website. But either way, very, very happy Rivian is scouting for another factory location. That's a good sign in my opinion. Not wasting money on advertising and marketing. They're just focused on how do we build more of these cars? Where are we going to build more batteries and that type of thing? So happy they're scouting for new locations. The other thing that got me excited is they're registering more Rivian names. So right now they've got two vehicles minus the delivery van, which is the R1T, R1S. They have a lot of similarities, obviously. I love their interiors and I love their design approach. and I honestly think the R1S is going to be pretty decent Model X competition now that it's $30,000 less. If we're talking about more full-size SUVs that can comfortably sit 7 adults, then I've seen this exact discussion go down in my Discord where a lot of people are leaning towards the R1S because it's substantially cheaper than the Model X, and deliveries for the R1S are supposed to be later this year, and new orders could be delivered sometime next year, depending on how this production ramp goes. So Model X is significantly delayed and significantly more expensive, plus those Falcon doors don't allow you to have a roof rack on the top. R1S does allow you to do that, and it's definitely being optimized for off-road driving, so I could see a demographic of people wanting to go after that. But these other registrations are the R2S, R3S, R4S, and R5S. They also have R2T, R3T, R4T, and R5T, so there's up to 5 different models that they're planning for both the truck and the SUV, and I don't know exactly what the dimensions or plans are for these other vehicles, but I like that Rivian is already forward-thinking to register these names because they have plans on making more trucks and SUVs. There were talks that they were looking to put a factory in Europe somewhere, and I've seen some rumors going around that they want to design smaller pickups and SUVs for the European market. So it's not necessarily confirmed that the R2T or R2S would be larger vehicles. They might actually be smaller ones that are optimized for Europe. They might look similar to the Rivians, but be a bit more compact, which I love personally. I think smaller trucks are underrated and they don't make enough of them anymore. So when I hear that Rivian's working on some smaller vehicles that might still be good at off-roading and utility, that gets me kind of excited for the future. But at the same time, I do think Rivian's biggest threat with the sales of the R1T is likely the F-150 Lightning. Ford is a very established brand with a huge fan base, and F-150 has just been a top-selling vehicle for decades now. And the F-150, a lot of its specifications and a lot of its most popular models are undercutting the Rivian R1S by quite a bit. Plus, the F-150 Lightning is a much larger vehicle, so I feel like if there was a direct threat against Rivian, F-150 Lightning and maybe the Cybertruck, but I feel like the markets are so different for those vehicles that they can probably coexist between people who want, you know, futuristic post-apocalypse truck versus, you know, let's go camping truck. However, F-150 Lightning is a bit more of a standard pickup design, which competes a bit more directly with the R1T, and the R1T costs a lot more. So I'm hoping what this means is Rivian is actually working on larger pickup trucks with larger beds that might actually compete more directly with the Cybertruck and the F-150 Lightning. High range, good efficiency, maybe lower prices. I'm not exactly sure what they have in mind here, but after seeing several in-person videos of the Rivian R1T, it's safe to say it's probably a lot closer in size to a Toyota Tacoma than it is an F-150, so big trucks in the United States sell a lot better than smaller trucks, so if Rivian does want to stand a chance against some of the big pickup truck players in the United States, they might want to have an extended version of the R1T, and maybe they want to call that something else, R2T, R3T, just so that they can expand their lineup a bit and have larger pickup trucks for those who are interested in them, and getting the names trademarked is, of course, an important step in that direction. I'm also very happy to see that Rivian has been launching service centers across the United States. They have some in California, some in New York, and of course several in between, which is a good thing because if people are taking these vehicles off-road, there's a good chance a lot of people are going to push them to their limits and probably even start breaking them. So building out service centers that are ready for customer deliveries is an important step. You absolutely want to get your service centers out before you get your product out. And I was very happy to see them meeting with some of their earliest pre-order holders who are still, of course, waiting for official deliveries to begin, but they let them drive around the pickups and check out the vehicles that are being produced out of the factory, which is operational. RJ said they have tested and calibrated, you know, over 100 different vehicles, so I think there's a lot of progress that has been made, and I don't believe Rivian is fraudulent. You know, I don't think they're trying to scam people. I just think that they likely overestimate how simple it is to get something to mass production, and that's why we keep seeing these, give us another month, give us another month, give us another month. So I hope that September can actually be the real one. Hopefully there's just deliveries of some kind by the end of this year, because I want to see another all-electric vehicle startup be delivering vehicles to customers that can be driven around and people are talking about them. So that hasn't happened in a long time, and I think Rivian's likely to be the next one. Another small point that I think Rivian might have a good opportunity to brag about by the end of this year is Tesla has announced the Supercharger network is going to work with all electric vehicles in the future. So once those adapters are out there, and once Tesla officially makes the announcement and updates the Tesla app to support all this, Rivian should be bragging about how their vehicles can charge at any Supercharger, you know? know? I think that the R1T size will probably allow it to fit in a supercharger better than it could a Cybertruck at a supercharger, which is much larger, and a lot of those stalls are pretty narrow, so I would not be shocked if Rivian wants to boast about that and say, hey, our charger network is being expanded, but also you can use superchargers. So lots of good things happening with Rivian, lots of things I'm excited for. I'm glad that the delivery vans are in use. I'm glad that they've got working models that are from the factory. You know, they're not prototypes, and they're having customers drive around in them, and they're looking for factory expansion. They're building out their service centers. They're including air compressors. Lots of great things. Just deliver the car, Rivian. You're so close. And of course, I would love to check one out as soon as humanly possible because it's a fairly exciting vehicle for me, and I wish them all the best of luck in the future. Thank you all for watching. Hope you have an excellent rest of your day.